Hey everybody, welcome back. This is our second part to our brake system. We've actually got these mounted up, and I've got the rear brakes shimmed, and we also have it on the other side. See there? And now what we want to talk about is that. That's our brake booster. And then we also have our clutch master cylinder as well. So we're going to hook that up. And that's why you'll see us running more than just two lines. The master cylinder is dual ported on both sides. We're actually going to pull off of one side, and we're going to use a proportioning valve, which will send brake fluid to the front brakes individually, and then the rear brakes as a set. So let's go talk about the proportioning valve. So this is our proportioning valve. It comes with a bracket that goes on to the GM style master cylinder and booster. And it has a number of different ports on here. These two ports are actually ports that come from the master cylinder. Kit comes with the hoses that you'll need for that. And then on the top here, you have one of your outputs for the driver's side, and then another output for the passenger side on the front brakes. And then in the back, you have a larger one that is for the rear brake system. And then up here under this rubber piece, you can get that done. That right there is our proportioning valve. So that's what will crank in and out to adjust the pressure front and rear for the system. Okay? So some of the other bits we're going to need is basically a brake line kit. This is just a generic brake line kit for front and rear brakes. It's all steel that is coated so that it doesn't corrode. We will need some of these guys. These are your flexible ends that will go onto the brake calipers themselves, because the suspension moves up and down. And then we will also need these guys to go from the dash 3 AN fittings to the inverted flare of the brake lines. In addition, we'll need some mounts for these guys. Those are incoming, so I've ordered those, and they're weld-on mounts, so we'll be able to weld those on, put this in there, and then clip it in. The other thing that you will need for the rear brakes is one of these guys, which is a T, so you feed in here, and then you left and right brakes out the sides. And then that can actually just bolt to the frame itself. On the clutch side, we got a bit of an issue which I haven't solved yet. This is goes to the slave cylinder for the clutch. And that is presumably some sort of metric gizzy. And then we've got this funky little bit of business coming out the backside. So we're going to have to figure out how we are going to be able to mate to that for the clutch line. But in the meantime, we'll just run a solid steel line for the clutch, and then we'll figure out how we're going to interface that later on. So that's all of the stuff. So we're going to go ahead and get started, and I'm going to just start putting in the lines. Now, for the lines, we have this little kit here where we have these little clips that we can use to nicely attach the lines to the frame. Don't zip tie them, don't do stuff like that. Do them the right way, which is this. So we will be drilling holes into the frame, tapping them, and then screwing these in to hold the brake lines in place nice and securely. That way it'll also keep the brake lines from chafing, rubbing off the coating, and then corroding down the line. So on the lines of everything doesn't go as it is planned, we have in here where we've actually moved our proportioning valve up here. The reason is because if I put it down here, it would actually interfere with our cantilever suspension. So I don't think the GM engineers, until they came out with the C8, ever envisioned that. And I'm not even sure the C8 has cantilever suspension anyway. So, but as you can see, we've found a solution. We'll see how it works, but that's where we're going to run our lines to. Now, these MC4 mechanical parking brake calipers from Wilwood are awesome. What can I say? They're inexpensive. I think they were around $100 when I bought them way long ago. But they have this clocking mechanism for where you want the brake cable to go. So I've clocked it the way I want it. I'm going to put it in and I'm going to show you how easy that makes it for the cables. And there you have it. So, and that cable goes right up front where it'll have the Audi brake handle. And we'll probably make some sort of bracket to make sure that we could secure that, since it was made for the kind of a T instead of this on the end. So anyway, pretty easy to fix. So there you go, brake cables. Now what I've done is we've rough run some of the lines, and then this is the one going towards the back. And as I told you, we were going to use clamps. And we're going to use these little guys. Now, what you may be wanting to do is just to kind of do this and clamp it. The problem with that is that you're pushing it up against the powder coat or the steel, and as this vibrates, it's going to rub, and it'll probably rub a hole through it. So you want to use one on the back and one on the front. And then that's how you want to secure those clamps. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go around. I'm not going to show you that, but I'm going to clamp all these lines up, get them all straightened out. The nice thing about this steel tubing is it's incredibly flexible without kinking. And so you can bend all of this stuff by hand. And if you don't like the way it sits, you rebend it. So on the next video, I'll show you it all prettied up. And then I'll show you where we put the junctions. As you can see right there, that junction right there. We'll put all the junctions in, weld and clip those. And then we'll get ready to fill and put fluid in the system. And that way we can have our brakes done. So, hope you enjoyed the video. Keep on watching. Thanks. Bye.